Seems like whether or not you hate or love the season's feature in NBA 2K22 is resulting in a lot of brand new content. Well, Season 3 is around the corner on December 3rd, so 2K decided to unveil to us all that is Season 3. Also, 2K dropped a patch that's changing the way that the game is played dramatically. So we gotta jump into all of it, ladies and gentlemen. If y'all new to the channel, be sure to subscribe. Drop a like on the video. Let's try and get this video to 15,000 likes.
Let's get into it.
Okay, so they first dropped this tweet here saying, Season 3 Iced Out is almost here. Showcase your clutch gene like Dame in our coldest season yet with new game modes and rewards. New game modes and rewards, that's what I like to hear. If every NBA 2K game has a cover athlete, Damian Lillard is like the season athlete, I guess for this one. You're gonna notice there's a lot of like ice cold and shooting from crazy deep limitless range. You're gonna notice a theme here. Well, first of all, 2K is showing us how they've redecorated the city and the boats on current gen to be a little bit more festive. So they put a whole bunch of trees and lights everywhere to fit the season. This is what the court looks like on current gen. In my opinion, gives me a little bit of NBA 2K18 vibes. I don't like how gray it is, but it only lasts for a season, so I guess you can stomach it. 2K jumps right into it and starts talking about some of the events that's gonna be dropping in Season 3. The first one they talk about here is called Fire and Ice. It basically speeds up the rate at which you earn the takeover perk. They say though, with every point scored, the takeover will begin a timed cooldown. Not opposed to it, seems like an interesting event. On current gen, there's gonna be 12 days of Xmas, where if you visit the tree, you can get a suite of different, they're arguing, useful rewards. So might as well, it's free, why not? So after those 12 days are complete, 2K saying there's gonna be events at the finale of those 12 days called Dunk the Halls event. In this event, if you're a high level player and you play with a low level player, your team gets double XP. I think some of y'all probably gonna cheat and just make new accounts, but it's a good effort from 2K to try and unite the community to play some more games together. They dropped some more screenshots here. This looks cool. I just like, there's nothing else to say about it. Northern Lights, you're playing in like the Arctic, I imagine. They say on PS4, Xbox One, Switch, and PC, Season 3 sees the boat charting a course to frigid waters. So that's the next stop in your cruise. If for whatever reason you wanted to take a cruise in the blistering cold, you can do that now in NBA 2K22. They say that for 30 minutes, you can look up into the starry night sky and see the spectacle for yourself. I guess the Northern Lights isn't gonna be permanently on. I guess they're looking for reasons to get you to wanna hop on, like, yo, the Northern Lights are coming on. Josh, hop on, let's play some twos. I don't know who the fuck would say that, but that's their goal. They want people to say that. So we referenced the new modes that 2K was talking about on the tweet earlier. They begin to talk about that here. I hate that it's a single player mode in an otherwise very multiplayer city. The premise goes like this. Convince skeptical street ballers to join your team by beating them on your own turf. I guess you win enough of those games and then you have like a city slam game and you're supposed to earn rewards. 2K says you get a championship belt and the whole purpose, I guess, of this event is that it's done on rooftops. So it'll be very scenic because, I mean, when was the last time we played on a rooftop outside of 3v3 Prime? It had to have been like 2K16, right? So it was the return of some more rooftop gameplay in NBA 2K22, except this time it's single player. So there's actually been some criticism towards 2K and some controversy in general about leveling up to level 40 in this season's meta. And some people were unhappy with how easy it was, others is unhappy with how challenging it is. It seems that nobody is like fully like on board with the way that you progress and level up in the seasons in NBA 2K22. 2K is looking to address some of those concerns here. They say, we want to address a change we're making to the way double XP coins work in 2K22 seasons. Starting at the beginning of Season 3, your 2 XP coins will not transfer from Season 2. That sucks. They say, we believe this will improve the season to season experience and competitive balance. 2 XP coins will now remain tied to the season they were acquired in. So I guess they're aiming to make it a little bit more challenging for people to hit level 40. Again, if you remember, they said if you hit level 40 in 4 seasons, then you get legend. So they have, I guess, truncated the legend race that we're so used to into different parts, almost like a relay. So instead of doing 400 meter race, they're doing 400 meter relay where each leg of the race is just 100 meters. I mean, I guess a lot of people, a lot of the tryhards in the community dislike this method, but it's the method that we have for 2K22, and 2K is looking to make some adjustments to hopefully, they say, add some competitive balance. And then they begin talking about the fresh new rewards. They didn't detail all the new rewards that will be dropped in Season 3 as you level up to level 40, but they show off some of the skins here. This is the Iced Out skin. They make a lot of reference to this in the article. Again, here we have the season athlete Damian Lillard. You see his arms is ice cold. This is actually the level 40 reward, and it's animated, so I guess if you enjoyed the skeletons in season 2, you might enjoy this animated skin here. I mean, I guess, as long as it looks cool, and people feel like it's worth grinding for. I feel like something functional beyond just aesthetics would be a good switch up from the last season, but what do I know? They also say that the level 30 reward differs from current gen to next gen. Next gen is gonna earn gliders, while current gen earns a BMX bike with lightning, so. That's a steep fall off. I guess if you're on next gen, this is a W for you. They also say there's some prizes if you win here. 100 wins at the rec, you get a helmet, and 100 3v3 games and you get a suit. I guess incentivizing you to play all factions of the game, not just one. And then they jump into the My Team stuff, which for the most part, I usually don't cover, but for the purposes of this video, they actually have a cool mode they added to My Team called Clutch Time. It's heavily revolved around Damian Lillard, the season athlete, but a lot like how they've had in some perk events in the past, they have a 4-point line now in My Team. And the whole mode is centered around just faster paced gameplay. The shot clock is quicker. If you make it into overtime, it's sudden death. The first person who scores wins. There's no substitutions. The 5 players you bring on is the 5 players you play with. And when you enter the final 2 minutes of the game, no matter how many fouls you and the other team has, you guys are both in the bonus. So I like it. It's a good switch up. 2K is really flexing their creativity with this one. Hopefully the My Team guys enjoy it. Y'all gonna have to let me know if you think this is worth playing. If I was a My Team head, I'd definitely try it out. So then I love when 2K does things like this. I wish they did it a lot more. They say you can earn a lot of rewards in this different mode. There's 50 different rewards and you're climbing a ladder. Each game you win, you get to the next level. But if for whatever reason you lose 3 games in a row, you have to reset. It is sucked that 2K servers are so bad, sometimes you just lag out and that's gonna count as a loss. But assuming the servers keep up and you guys can fucking play your game with no lag and no issues, I love this right here. My Team's getting a Dame Signature Challenge. If you're into Dame Signature Challenges, then why not, man? Go ahead and play it. And then they talk a little bit about updates to the W Online, which I'm not gonna lie, I read it over a couple times and it sounds like they didn't add much of anything. They just had to include it here, I guess, for the purposes of. And then the final thing they talk about as it relates to season 3 updates is the new artists that they're dropping. They say there's a combination of up and coming artists and established artists, and the list of 10 songs is here. In my opinion, why not just play Spotify in the background? But if you are the type of person to keep on game music, then you should be excited to know that there's new music in the game. Well, then 2K didn't stop there, because immediately after they posted all the season 3 updates, they followed up with this tweet here saying, "Our latest patch is live on new gen and current gen with many updates, including the preparation for season 3, gameplay fixes, player likeness updates, and more." So this is actually, at least for me, where it begins getting exciting, because 2K adding a bunch of new content is fantastic. It gives me a reason to hop on, and maybe I could convince some of my friends to finally play the game. So 2K gets right to the punch with the current gen patch update 1.8. This one is huge. They slowed down lateral dribble launches and added a shooting penalty that applies for players who zigzag from side to side excessively before shooting. The metrics at which they decide someone is zigzagging excessively, I don't know, but this is obviously a clear attack on the play shots who zigzag non-stop. And this happens on current gen, and there's no stopping it. No matter what game you play, it's zigzagging, boost, zigzag, boost. 2K is saying here that they're looking to do something about that. The guys who do it, you should be highly upset right now, I'm not gonna lie, because you're probably gonna have to start dribbling like me. And that's tough for you. They say they fixed an issue that was causing ball handlers to hitch and slow down while running in transition. We all know about this, so hopefully when they say they fixed the issue, they fixed the issue. And they say they adjusted the Intimidator badge to apply to jump shots in addition to dunks and layups. Intimidator badge was an all-time badge in previous 2Ks. This year, not as useful, so I guess a buff here to the Intimidator badge, hoping that more people equip and use it. So those are the current gen updates. Now to the next gen updates. So 2K did the same zigzag nerfs on next gen, they're saying. They fixed the same hitch when running in transition for next gen as well. Same update to the Intimidator badge as well. But now they begin citing some new gameplay changes. They say defensive positioning logic improvements have been made to help CPU screen defenders guard the pick and roll more effectively. They also cite stability and performance improvements for the 40th time on these patch notes to the city. So I'll hop on, we'll see if there are any improvements or if it just continues to deteriorate. So between those two updates, a lot should change. The meta of 2K was just play shots, zigzag, zigzag, and zigzag some more. While it's exciting to have a fast-paced game, there has to be more than one fast-paced move. Everyone's doing the same thing and it requires very little skill to pull off. Well, it's not much of a move then, is it? So we'll see how this plays out. There have been 2Ks in years past where 2K nerfed a very overpowered move and the community disliked it. The sentiment was, instead of removing the one good move, why don't you add more good moves so that it's not just a suite of different bad moves that we have to choose choose from. We'll have to wait days to see how the dribbling community reacts to the changes that were made, because they'll inevitably either come up with a new way to do something just as effective. Maybe it'll improve the gameplay. Maybe we'll see a little bit more parity and variety when we're hopping in from game to game. But it also means that people who've created builds specifically to take advantage of the zigzag might be out of luck. I mean, the patch notes look promising, but we have to hop on the game and see how it's actually gonna play out. I imagine this is gonna be a pretty controversial update just due to the fact that a lot has changed. The hope is that 3 months from now, it'll be like the game is better as a result. But who knows? It's the NBA 2K update. There's no knowing for sure. Just off the initial reactions I'm seeing on Twitter, it's very split. Some people believe that the gameplay feels way too slow, and others believe that it provided some balance to the game, so it was necessary. But no matter which way you land, I know for a fact that we can all agree you need to smash that like button, man. Of course you do. Drop a like. Yeah. Okay, I'm joking. My fault, guys. I'm gonna hop on later tonight because I'm on a trip tomorrow, so I don't really have much time, but I wanna experience it for myself, see if it has truly ruined and or made the game great again. On that note, if y'all wanna catch me on stream, click the link in the description. It's twitch.tv/callmeagent00. Otherwise, there's a video right here where some TikTokers drop some gems on NBA 2K22 that you don't wanna miss out on. Catch you guys in the next one. Peace.